Rich is checking out some of the new features in iOS 17, which is available as a public beta.
Here is now sharing his advice on whether you should download the as yet unfinished version of the software. That's what beta means. It's
exactly.
In testing.
Yes.
And if I can remember your advice, it's no.
If you're the average person that's just trying to use your phone on a daily basis, probably not.
Yeah.
You're a little tech savvy, you've got a secondary device, absolutely. This is what I look like in the new iOS 17, baby
you're a baby.
Rich.
Well, did you upload a picture or it just goes through all your pictures and said, or is that just a random one you select?
This is a Memoji. And so this is what you can now have show up on someone else's phone when you call them. That's one of the new features.
Did it just do that based on kind of your
I kind of created that, but it made what it thought was, yeah. It doesn't do facial yet, but it does, it went off. Apple has released what they call a public beta of iOS 17, the new software that's coming to the iPhone in the fall. Anyone can download it to test it out and try these new features. Here's a look at some of the things it can do.
Contact Posters is a new feature that lets you customize what the screen looks like when you call someone else's iPhone. There are options for the background, your name, and image. Name Drop lets you hold two iPhones together to quickly exchange contact information. Standby is a new way to see information when your phone is charging on its side. You can display the time, calendar, photos, and more. Check out the special animation for the timer.
New in Maps, you can now download areas to use directions offline, which is handy if you don't have a connection or if your cellular is spotty. If you change your passcode and can't remember what it is, a new setting will let you use your old one for a grace period of 72 hours. And how many one-time authentication codes do you have lingering in your texts? Now iOS 17 has an option to delete it as soon as you're done with it.
In Reminders, you can now have the app automatically sort your grocery list into departments.
It may not be perfect, but it's helpful if you like to stay organized. One more big change, you no longer have to say, "Hey Siri," now you can just say, "Siri."
Uh-huh.
Because we all know "Hey" is for horses, but if you like the old way, that still works too. Speaking of voice, dictation is seriously improved. It gets things right the first time around.
Messages gets a bigger, bolder look for attaching things. Check-in will automatically text a friend to let them know you've arrived safely. Messages also lets you have fun by creating cutout stickers from photos.
Finally, iOS 17 is easier on the eyes with a bigger magnifier, so it's easier to select text.
Are you doing this on purpose? Okay.
Okay, one more feature in iOS 17. It's called Personal Voice. This is a feature that lets you recreate your voice using AI and machine learning. So it took me 150 different phrases I had to read. Let me call it up here. 1, 2, 3. And here we go. This is what I sound like.
What's going on? I'm Rich DeMuro, and this is Rich on Tech, the show where I talk about the tech stuff I think you should know about and answer your questions about technology. I believe that tech should be easy, helpful, inspiring, and fun. Phone lines are now open.
That's the intro to the radio show I did. So now I can just have my AI do the radio show on the weekends.
Man.
So somewhat close, but
yes.
Not really.
It's close,
yet.
But you have to remember this is the
testing.
This is the first version of this feature.
Yeah, 5 years from now it'll be seamless.
Yeah. I mean, just imagine where that can go.
So crazy.
So it took overnight. I had to read 150 phrases, and then it pieces them together overnight. It builds your voice. And so it took about 24 hours.
Did you have to do stuff like, "My dog has fleas"?
It was a lot of like constitutional. It was like, Hawaii was the 50th state in the U.S. Whatever, I don't know if that's true, but it was like a lot of that kind of stuff. Anyway, if you want more information about iOS 17, you can go to my website. It is richontech.tv. No one's getting fooled right now by that.
No.
No.
But it's coming, sadly. All right, Henry.
Good stuff, as always. Mm-hmm. Rich,
depressing
news.
Stuff. It's a little depressing.
Funny you say that. When I was recording my voice, I was very sad. Because
I know.
It's like, this will live on forever.
Serious question.
I will not.
Serious question. Does Apple have rights to your voice?
It's stored on the phone, so it is not.
It's not uploaded to, like,
the
cloud.
Well, you can share it across your devices, so I believe it would be, but it's encrypted, and Apple does not.
Have the rights to use it.
Yeah.
Okay.
As far as I know.
Yet.
No. I don't think Apple would do that.
I don't know. It's all crazy.
Of course they wouldn't.
Companies are trustworthy.
Yeah. All right, we're going to talk